now, is that better? Hey, I am Professor Alisa Bucchiere. I am the head of the music department, and I am so happy to welcome you to the very first Battle of the Bands. We've got four fantastic bands playing tonight. We've got Out of Water. Take one, please. Open. We've got neck dive and wait, four symbols is not is third, not fourth, and out of water. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our order. So what will happen, my dear bandmates, is you have 5 minutes to set up the stage to your liking. You have your 20-minute set list. We have everyone give it up for Emmy Cisco. UMass Lowell, that music person, graduated here from music, and is, oh my gosh, graphic designer on the side, too. So she has taken the logos you've given me and given us up. If you hit any of the QR codes with your phone, it will take you to whichever band we have up, any of their social media. These bands are taking it out there. They're on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, if you ask, Spotify even. So by all means, make sure you get their QR code. And I know I spy on many of the tables updated next gigs for all of these bands of where they're playing next. So make sure you grab some. Without, after they've done their 20-minute set, then the judges will give you some feedback, and then you have 5 minutes to break down, and then shampoo. Lather, rinse, repeat 3 more times the same way. Are you ready? Are you ready? Fantastic. Let it go.
Thank you. start now.
Yeah.
that's why I stay here, just to keep you near. Floating ocean after ocean, moving transcendental, and my mind is free. When you run away with, we'll go somewhere far away, and we won't tell them where we're going.
Back in the sitting on the bed, one more hit, one more. audience participants stand right here. Stand up if you think trans rights are human rights.
Yeah.
backs of my hand. God has been
Dragonfruit. I really enjoyed that. Yeah. You guys have so much charisma. I really felt connected to you. Even the bass player had a lot of charisma, would you know? Yeah. You can't always count on it, you know. So thanks. I enjoyed it.
Well done, Paul. You pretty much said everything that I was going to say. Let me add, I love the little plushy mascot. I think that's great.
My name's Darla.
Even better. So where's my man on the rebel bass? Did you do that on purpose?
You what?
The Star Wars shirt while you're playing bass. The rebel bass, right? You kind of threaded the needle. You were grooving really well without overplaying, but sometimes you could kind of drift a little bit into maybe a little bit of, like, getting desynchronized from the drums, right? So just making sure, springing off of what Paul said, just make sure you're listening to each other and kind of locking that in. Because when it worked really well, especially in that bridge. Was it the Lizzie May song, where it kind of broke down for a while, then you brought it back up and hit right at the same time, and that was really effective. And you heard it in the audience, too. So make sure that you're really locked in. That's the one thing I'll say about that. But stage presence was great. Transitions between songs was great. Interaction with the audience was great. Really well done.
Can I just piggyback on that real quick? That Lizzie May tune, you guys had awesome dynamics. If you paid that much attention in all your tunes, it would be fire. The first song, there was like the drummer was like doing this build up, and the string players were just like jang 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 jang. I was like shh, bring it down. But you did really well on Miss Lizzie May, and I think like when you're hit the practice room next, like work on that stuff because that stuff makes a big difference.
All right, let's give out one more round for Dragonfruit! And we invite Nick Dive up to the stage, get set up, dun dun dun! Now, one of the things that just happened here in Northern Essex, and about a month or so ago, we had this big signing of like the Magna Carta. But basically it was UMass Lowell and Northern Essex are now have joint admissions. But let me tell you, all of us in here, many of you, right? One of the conditions to be a band playing in this thing, in this fantastic event, is you need to be a Northern Essex music student or an alumni. And guess where a lot of our alumni have gone? UMass Lowell. All right, so in the room, if you are a current or an alumni, Northern Essex music student, raise your hand. What? Look at them. Oh my gosh, multi-generational, fantastic. All right, you ready? If you're a UMass Lowell music student or graduate, raise your hand. Fantastic schools and music has melded the two together. And so we're gonna get Neck Dive up next, give them their set list. Thank you, Amy, again for fixing all the slides. Woo!
Thank you. Hey, what's up, everyone? We're Necktie. We're so excited to do the Battle of the Bands. We just want to thank Alisa Bucchiere for putting it all together. Can we get a round of applause?
Shout out Four Symbols, Out of Water, and Dragonfruit. Dragonfruit just kicked ass, and we're super excited to play.
Now that is a bass player with charisma, right? All right, without further ado, can you give me a beat?
We'll be right back.
This next song is off our EP. It's our first song off our EP. It's called Letter to the Drifted. We're kind of a band where we want people to come on up. If anyone wants to come up and stand in this little space, like, there's an open space for a reason. Get on up. I got free stickers down here. Free stickers over here. Free stickers. Who wants a free sticker? Come on. We traded out kicks. We got three more songs left for you. This next one is called Give a Shit. I want you guys to move around, by the way. Who wants some more free stickers? We got free stickers over there. Grab a fucking sticker. Thank you. I gotta introduce our new guitar player, James McNulty, over here. I know, I talk too much, so he's gonna do this next song we gotta cover.
You talk way too much.
Close enough.
Thank you.
got more stickers if anyone wants stickers. We have t-shirts now if anyone wants t-shirts. Thank you guys for rocking out with us. Get ready for Four Symbols up next, then Out of Water. Thank you, Passion Fruit, for killing it in the beginning. That's a bass player with charisma over there. Good night, everyone.
For the band that just played, getting people excited for the bands that are coming up, or just getting people excited. Quick question, who is the band that started your set? Because it's not the same band that ended your set.
we didn't practice this week. We missed practice. But...
Don't tell me that.
Hey, I'm being for real. I keep it real.
Appreciate that. But as soon as you called the audience up to the front, you noticed the energy changed, right?
Yeah.
That was great. And I started paying attention. Everyone started paying attention. All right, that's the energy this band needs. Yeah, so gear screw-ups happen, and I think you handled that well. Whether it was like weirdness with your wireless rig or pedal board malfunctions or the bass drum pedal deciding to...
I fixed it, it's good.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm talking about. You know, the last thing you want is dead space on stage, and you did not do that. I thought that was great. You improvised a little Billie Jean bass moment, and there's some guitar squeedlies happening, and it filled the space. I'm like, is this an interesting intro to their next song? But, oh, wait, that's not what they're doing. Well done. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, well, Cade, clearly we have more than one bassist with charisma here. That was awesome. I'm kind of catching my breath. I've enjoyed a show like that for a while, so thank you so much.
Thank you.
Amazing vocals. I thought everything was really tight. And, you know, James, I thought your background vocals on the last song were lovely. And I would say sing more, James.
James McNulty, ladies and gentlemen.
I had the same exact thought. I really liked it when James was singing. Is your old guitar player in the room?
No.
Well, you made the right choice. Yeah, James, you're a lightning bolt up there, man. Really fun to watch. I enjoyed watching you a lot. I loved you joked that Cade, is it?
Yeah.
You joked that Cade talks too much, but what you do really well is like just throw some feedback behind while he's trying to say something. And I love that. I think it's like grunge and fuzz rock and everything that you guys do. And what you do really well. It's like, you know, it's not my total cup of tea, but you do it awesome, and it was really fun to watch.
Thank you.
Jasper, dude, next time you rehearse, try just playing with a kick drum, a snare, and some cymbals. For real, like, I think that would, like, just for like the image on stage for what you guys are doing, because you play a lot of just like, and you throw your kick drum in there a lot, and I just think it would make you play a little different and maybe even a little heavier, which I don't think would be a terrible thing for you guys. I was just thinking that. I'm like, I want to take those toms away from that kid and just let him just rip on a tiny little kid. And the last thing I'll say is someone once told me when you play a show, make the crowd think you're a little bit crazier than they are. And you guys do a really good job at that. I watch you guys, man. These guys are crazy.
So much, guys.
And you should always drink a 5-hour energy.
for the record, we sometimes give out earplugs for...
solid idea.
But if anyone wants a sticker or anything, I'm giving out stickers free. You can have them. We have t-shirts over there. Thank you so much for seeing us. I'm so excited for the next bands.
We're Four Symbols. We're a live Led Zeppelin tribute. We're doing mix of 73 and earlier renditions. It's kind of song remains the same-y, but with better words.
Yeah.
Let's hear it for all the bass players with charisma tonight. And same as the last band, if you want to come up here and rock out with us, feel free.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
cymbals. Sean, it's nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
That was so impressive. I mean, you captured the artistry of Zeppelin and really made it your own. So impressive. And I have a great job here tonight because I get to sit here and just enjoy the music. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. I didn't write much because I was just like loving the show, you know? So I second that. I guess my only thought is... No, you're great. John Paul Jones didn't have much charisma, so you nailed it. No, I'm sorry, I'm just kidding. The tribute band thing is so hot right now, right? Like, there's a lot of people doing it, and you guys are super talented. Like, everyone up there, like, blowing me away a little bit. And I want to see you take it further. Like, you two, I feel like I'm watching Zeppelin, and you guys have the talent, but I need you to look like them. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, drop the hair down, like, yeah. Take me there. And then I guess the other thought is, I have this thing here on my page that says transition time between songs. You guys were awesome. It was quick. And then the one down moment was like, you guys didn't say anything. And I wonder if just like in the spirit of a tribute band, just like a little homework on YouTube, like literally take some, like something, literally transcribe whatever Robert Plant says to the crowd.
Yeah,
and
he said a lot.
Yeah, like just be there, you know.
We've
like
talked about that. Right?
Yeah, I think if you guys just do that and bring the gong, of course, every time. That was really, really fun. Nice job, guys.
Thank
yeah.
You,
just like dress the part and we're there.
Well, once again, Paul, you read my mind. You know, get a couple of Froofy shirts and you'll look great. As a veteran of several tribute bands myself, it's really hard to pull off because everyone knows the songs already.
Yeah, that's right.
And you've definitely done your homework. There's something to be said about plugging a guitar directly into an amp and just like getting all your sounds that way,
yeah,
right?
Led Zeppelin in 73
did that. Yes, I mean, of course. You know, the one downside to that is when you dial in the sound, make sure it's not too much. You know, I love the vocals, I love the bass playing. I just wish I could hear it more. So make sure you sound great, but don't try not to overpower everyone. Because, you know, with great power comes great responsibility. Right?
We always have trouble balancing the guitar.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But that being said, that's literally the only downside to that. Nice job, guys.
Thank you.
Dragonfruit, four cymbals, and Necdive for crushing it tonight. We've got some pretty big shoes to fill, but hopefully we can live up to it. We were really blown away by all their performances, so thank all of you for coming out tonight, and I hope you enjoy. Yeah.
I know it all falls
This next one's called Weird.
Thank you.
far. Stay put. Judges have something to say to you. Oh, yes! Woo-hoo!
All right. Damn, y'all talented. All four of yous. Like, really, really talented. I love your note choices. Like, your melodies. I just like, where is she going? Like, oh my gosh, what a cool choice she just made. You're kind of, don't take this the wrong way. Do you know Fits in the Tantrums? You guys sound like nothing like them. But there's that singer in the group, Noelle Skaggs, and you remind me of her. You're just like, even when you're not part, like you're not playing, you're just like, I can't stop watching you, you know? Which is really, 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 really fun. I will say though, there are moments when like the three of you are going nuts, and it's cool, it's like, it fuels my ADHD, you know? I'm like, yes, 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 yes. And then you take a breath, and those are my favorite parts. When you guys like come down, like that vibe in that last song, Weird, that was, like that you start with, just like, doom, 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 just like ominous. I love like coming, I wrote my favorite part was, it was coming out of the guitar solo in Mars. Like as you guys came out of it, it just like went, and I was like, there it is, I can breathe now. And I think you guys could benefit a lot from some of that. Cause like it's, I mean, or don't listen to what I said, but I just, cause you're all really, and it's like really fun to watch. But like for a while I'm like, I don't know what's going on. And then like you guys come together and like everyone chills out for a second and it's like, ah, more moments like that. I thought that was really special when you guys did that. And like I gave you a chance to like, check out these weird notes I'm singing. But yeah, holy crap, nice job. Really good.
I really enjoyed that. I loved the last two songs in particular. And what a great way to bring this evening to a close with that beautiful lullaby, that last song. I did like the quiet parts as well. And I agree, I think you have an incredible, you're an incredible performer. So you use that energy and so much talent on the stage. Thank you so much. I also just want to say thank you, Professor Bucchiere, for putting this together.
Yes, really well done. One of the things that I really find myself doing is whenever someone is clearly being featured, I like to look at what everyone else is doing. It's like, okay, great, yeah, guitar solo, okay, singer, whatever. But not that you're not great. But one of the things that I really enjoyed was you are all paying attention to each other and you're really into what each other is doing, which is great to watch. You're clearly entertained by it and that translates out here so well. At one point, you even played air guitar on the mic cord, and that was great. One of the things that I really don't like seeing is when, okay, there's a guitar solo, everyone else just kind of looks bored, like, when is he done? Like, whatever. But you brought the energy, and the arrangements were great, the dynamics were great. I love the mixed meter stuff, especially in the last tune. Well done. Well done.
Before you go too far, this is what I need, please, because this is going to be an amazing photo. And please give it up for our media, social media, everyone who's been helping us here in front of us. Jessica! Our favorite saying in the music department is hashtag, which is actually a sharp song. Hashtag NECO Music Thrives, and as you see tonight, it really has. Holy cow. What I need right now is all the performers up on stage. We need a big group photo, please. Bring it on! Bring it up! I want the judges up here, too, please, and thank you. Whoa!
Wait.
Thank you, Houston. Give it up for Houston!
Thank you.
a luau. Tonight has been such a celebration of music. I want to personally thank all the performers for sharing their amazing music.
Decision. And it wasn't easy.
We went back and forth a couple times.
Yeah, we did. Me and Jared almost got into a fist fight. But let me first and foremost say that all of you up there are super talented. This was so much fun. I've never done something like this. I've been up there, like you guys, but I've never like judged it. And it was so much fun to watch you guys all perform and like switch my brain every time the band changed, you know, like, all right, get in that mode. All right, I'll stop rambling. We chose the winner pretty much based on, it was hard to, I'm going to say this wrong, but everyone up there is so insanely talented, and what we came to a conclusion was, like, which band did what they do the best, kind of thing, right? Because, like, you could sit there and, I mean, Out of Water just blew our minds, right? They were just, like, insanely talented. Four Cymbals took us to a place, you know, from the 70s. Neck Dive made us all feel a little crazy. Dragonfruit just had, like, beautiful, beautiful songs. But I guess who we decided on, the band that did what they do the best and that we all agreed, if we drove home and it came on the radio, we'd be like, oh, that's them. The winner tonight is Neck Dive. Yeah! And it's not because you brought merch. And you had a strike against you because the drummer was wearing shorts, but all the drummers were wearing shorts. Except Dragonfruit's drummer didn't wear shorts, so. No shorts on stage. Nice job, though. Really, really enjoyable to listen to all you guys. It was a really, really fun night. So thank you.
But wait, there's one more thing that Neck Dive not only has bragging rights until next year. Neck Dive, congratulations. You've just won a recording session at Zach Fields Drum and Music. All of you are amazing. Thank you so much for being here and sharing this music. Your music was phenomenal. I can't wait till next year. Thank you so much, everyone.